In 1958, Balanchine extended to Violette Verdy a rare invitation.
Balanchine was on the telephone introducing himself and asking me if I would be interested to dance in his company. And I could not believe it, because I had not thought that I was a dancer for him. And that was another thing, that I never thought of who I, you know, no, I didn't think of that, that, you know, I might be a principal. First of all, I never thought of Balanchine because I didn't think I was a Balanchine dancer. By then, the legend was firmly established that he had a company of greyhounds and borzois. And, you know, I was a little French poodle, but I was not a borzoi.
Violette was the exception to the rule because he never took outside people. He usually developed later on his dancers from within, like I joined from his school. Balanchine took some of the men, like Jean-Pierre came to the company from the outside, but it was very unusual that he would take a ballerina.
Well, you know, it was interesting because when I saw her, she was with New York City Ballet, and it was at the time when, you know, there was sort of a stereotype body and a stereotype dancer that Balanchine was using. And she wasn't exactly that stereotype dancer. And when she got on the stage, I don't care who else was on the stage, she was the one you watched. She was the one that lit up the stage. I mean, there are many wonderful dancers that just come on stage and technically do everything. She not only was a brilliant technician, I mean, her feet moved faster than I've ever seen feet move, but it was just that personality that you see every day was even more magnified on the stage. Just came across the lights and just got you in your heart.
Rather than evaluate what I did, which is maybe less objective, I will tell you what Balanchine told me. It's very nice because he told me. He said, you have very eloquent feet. You said you speak with your feet. And he said, that's very French in a way. It pours in like the most wonderful, easy moment. It's like sharing a very good gourmet meal, because he comes through with steps that fit the music so perfectly. I always said, dancing for him, the steps, it's the only possible solution. It's the best solution. You see the steps and you say, that's it. Nothing else could be there except what he did. And also, if he didn't like what you did with it right away, and he say, I think I need to change it. So, Mr. B, I love that stuff. I'm going to work on it. I'll make it look good. I promise, I'm going to work. No, dear, I have another one. Because he knew that maybe there was something better there to be done.